Hi, I'm Weimin Tan of Castle Avenue Partners. Today I'm going to talk about the differences between Hong Kong property versus Manhattan property. Number one, I think, is appreciation. Hong Kong property is more volatile. They can go up 40% one year, they can come down 40% one year. But in Manhattan, it's more stable. It goes up an average of 10% per year. So in terms of price appreciation potential, Hong Kong has higher appreciation potential, but of course, more risk. Number two, I think, is the demand. Hong Kong property is driven by demand from China, so it's largely dependent upon one country. Whereas Manhattan property, the demand is number one by local buyers who are buying to live there, as in New Yorkers, and number two by foreigners. But with regards to the foreigner population, there's a lot of countries who whose citizens want to buy in Manhattan, New York. For example, there's demand from Canada, Mexico, Europe, China and Hong Kong, Singapore, Malaysia, Latin America, and so forth. So there's a much larger diversity of demand for Manhattan properties. And I think number three is the tax rate. And obviously, Hong Kong being Hong Kong, the tax rate is lower than New York property. Those, I think, are the three big points. Thank you.